Shirley, it was 2 years ago this Friday. Police officer Milton Green was shot by a fellow officer, leaving him unable to return to work. Green says the city has been dragging its feet on the investigation, and now he's at risk of losing his home.
The moment he was shot, everybody knew that he was shot by a fellow officer.
In June of 2017, a chase involving St. Louis police and a stolen car came to an end near Park and Astra in the city's North Point neighborhood. St. Louis police said the suspects and officers exchanged gunfire. The lawsuit says three suspects inside the car got out and ran past the home of off-duty police officer Milton Green, who was in his driveway. One of the suspects pointed his gun at Green. Green drew his service weapon, identified himself as police, and told the suspect to drop his gun. The suspect ran. Uniformed officers arrived and ordered Green to drop his gun and get on the ground. Green complied, identified himself as an officer, and showed his badge. The lawsuit says a detective allowed Green to get up and told other officers Green was police. The suit alleges Green was giving the detective a description of the suspect when Officer Christopher Tanner arrived on the scene, shouted, "Drop your weapon," while simultaneously shooting Green in the arm. Green's family witnessed the incident. Green was rushed to the hospital for emergency surgery.
Anybody that kept into the emergency room, I told them what happened. My story never changed. It's not going to change then. It's not going to change now. I told them what happened.
Yet that was not the story provided by the then interim police chief that night.
An off-duty officer who lives in that area heard the commotion, came out of his house to render assistance, and during the exchange of gunfire, he was struck in his arm.
Green says he has gone through 6 months of physical therapy. He has a plate from his elbow to his wrist and lasting effects.
It's numb. It hurts. These two fingers, sometimes I get the shakes. I get shooting pains through it.
He says he can't do simple tasks around the house and he can't do his job.
Can't carry a gun. Tried to hold, to squeeze it. Can't squeeze it.
Green became an officer to support his family and to make a difference in the community where he grew up.
It was, if you could save one life that day, feel like you did your job, especially in the city of St. Louis.
Now he's at risk of losing his home, and he isn't able to provide for his four children, who are still trying to make sense of what happened to their dad.
I had my badge out, and they said, "Well, why did he still shoot you?" Their trust is rough. They're scared.
Green's attorney, Javad Kazali, says the city's unwillingness to meet with Green left them with no other options than to file suit.
And instead of taking responsibility and backing Officer Green, the city has abandoned him.
The city says it does not comment on pending litigation. Two 17-year-olds were arrested with that original incident, and two guns were recovered. A third suspect got away. Now, despite the police saying that these suspects were driving a stolen vehicle and fired multiple shots at police that night, the circuit attorney's office says the charges against the defendants were dismissed and the matter remains under investigation. Live from the Stiefel Theater News Bureau, Katie Kormann, Fox 2 News.